Votes for women.
Votes for women.
Votes for women.
Thank you.
Votes for women. Votes for women.
On the 25th of October 1910, she had determined Hanna, Sheehy, Skeffington and Hilda, Webb were to draw attention to the lack of acknowledgement and support for women's voting rights in Ireland. What ensued was a somewhat amusing turn of events and evidence of history being on our doorstep.
To receive, this would not be a priority.
A priority? You would not hear our views, and so you have left us no alternative but to approach you in this way, and we will continue to do so every time you appear in public.
Gender, you obstreperous woman! Police!
Ladies, please. I'm an advocate of your cause. The Irish suffrage movement is building momentum with your significant contribution. I've been authorised to state that the Chief Secretary will receive your deputation for women's suffrage this coming Friday.
Thank you very much. That shows there's something to be gained by putting some pressure. Even the Chief Secretary.
How could I tell that them ones have turned to Greystones Harbour?
The public were being informed of the changes in Irish society. Suffragettes were holding their own and showed excellent ability in public speaking. They eventually gained respect and attention as the movement gained momentum. This episode, reported by the Irish Times at the time as no more than an amusing scene, was described by a contemporary historian as the first step towards militant action by the Irish suffragette movement.
In months to come, a number of Irish Women Franchise League members were imprisoned both in Ireland and England for militant activities, and some, including Hanna Sheehy Skeffington, went on hunger strike. The campaign achieved partial victory in the 1918 general election, when women over 30 voted for the first time. And in 1922, the Irish state extended the franchise to women on the same terms as men, bringing an end to a struggle whose final stage had begun and that almost forgotten in